Yes, I think schools have a long way to integrating themselves well and getting down from the high throne that they seem to have built into this little kingdom in the middle of the city for themselves. Please stay out of the high walls, stay out of the gates. Parents only enter the school to pay the fee or during the parent teacher meeting, where all they get back from the school is he or she is good, but she can do better. Mm-hmm. And they go back for 12 years, four times a year, can do better. That's all slipped on the report card. That's all that the school wants to talk to them about. School has their own domain, the teachers have their own domain. Don't tell me how to teach. If you don't want a child to study here, please withdraw your child. So I think schools have to be a part of the community in terms of right from as a responsibility as an institution to even setting an example for children as well, for their own children, because to be a part, you cannot work in isolation from the community. When you go outside and work, you have to learn to be a part of the community. What fun is it if you're a big geek who can't even talk, knows anybody in the community? So I think the thing starts from right from the architecture, in fact. When you start planning a school, that's one of the philosophies that we have. We look at, first of all, when people come with this layout, they say, we want to make a school, I said, great, so what's it going to be? And look at the elevation, sorry, it looks just like a mall. So we're not making a mall, I'm sorry, did we ask you to make a mall? So we want that, you know, the architecture, the elevation should give a look, should be integrated with the community. So it gives a feel to the community, yes, this is a part of us as well. They feel, otherwise they are still in their mindset that, you know, there's a school coming up, will they listen to us? The principal's coming, Why not? Principal's job is to teach your children, he's there to serve you. So we try and integrate local materials into the design, first of all, in the elevations, and look at the buildings around. So it doesn't stand up like a sore thumb. If it's, they have local materials like stone, so we try and integrate so it looks as a part of the people feel a sense of ownership among the school. And even in business terms, it's a better thing if people feel that it's our school, they feel proud about it, rather than, oh, it's a school which is open, it's a corporate, some has opened a McDonald's kind of a school. No, it's not like that. We want to be a part of the community. So we don't standardize our elevations for that matter. So our buildings don't look the same. Consciously, it's not that we could not do it, we could do it, but we consciously want to look like whatever. So if it's on the hills, so it looks like it will not have the same feeling as something on the plains as well. So it has different things. Second stage is one, the elevation. Second is the master planning now. For example, we plan the building in a way the library and common facilities can be shared with the public in the evening. With the school children only, or you can have only children coming over, if you can manage it, or you can have children and adults use the library in the evening. Why not? I mean, once people have a sense of ownership over your project, they'll recommend the school to hundreds of other people as well. Isn't this free marketing for you? If a person comes and uses a computer, what is he going to use out of it? Just keyboard? A keyboard costs 300 rupees. How much is he going to type? Right? So why not let them use it? And they feel proud to be associated with the school. So this is how we tell our franchisees who sometimes come with all their own notions of what a traditional school would look like. So we tell them we have to put in sense of it means good. It's good for your business as well. And if you get, so we say, okay, let's plan the library in a way that in the evening we want to open it. The rest of the school can be cut off. You don't want children going in the corridors at night, in the evening, girls and boys going there. So the library is over there in the front. It can be used. They get children and people can go out. The rest of the school cannot be accessed. So library, computer facilities. That's something that we do in the master planning. And while we're training them, we also tell them, you know, volunteer your school for different things in the community. For example, the IAS Association, the Punjabi Association, the VASH Association, the JAN Association, they all need areas to meet. And they end up renting up some banquet hall, which is expensive for them. Volunteer your place for them. Don't charge them money. Once they have I have to set it like a goodwill thing for them. See, when they feel good about you, they'll recommend you to other parents as well. At the same time, what I know is, once people feel that this is part of our community, it actually helps. And I think that's a approach that schools are taking up. They are opening up their gates now to people to come and, you know, use our facilities. I think the sports facilities can be used by children. You can set up an academy for not even your own students. Other children can also come and play in the evening. Why not? What is the ground doing in the evening? Nothing. Why not open it to children? Let there be a feel-good factor about your school as opposed to people talking negatively about your school. So these are opportunities which doesn't cost us anything, but a school can easily reach out to the community. I think this is something which sets an example for children that they are not just little isolated people who have to write wonderful pieces of code and be successful sitting in their room. It's about making a happier society at the end of the day. And if everyone's happy, then everyone's happy.